And first of all, I'd like to invite to picture Joan Humphreys from Dundee, whose grandson has died in Afghanistan.
Afghanistan 54 days ago on the 31st of August, he was 24 years old. Since his death, another 12 British soldiers have been killed, roughly averaging one every 4 days, and we'll never know how many Afghanis have died in that time. Our great sorrow, but also anger at Kevin's death. It's not directed to the people of Afghanistan. My anger is towards the current and present governments of Britain and the United States of America. The Afghani people are only doing what anyone would do on being invaded. They are defending themselves. My grandson was the young man whose ambition was to be in the military. When he was younger, he often accompanied me on supporting the campaign for nuclear disarmament. He was in the army because he could see no future for himself in civilian life. I started to tell you about what future as a soldier. But I know that with a decent education and a country run by honest politicians, he and many others would be given a chance to fulfill their dreams out of the military. Please understand, most of the young men who are in the service have done it against the people of Afghanistan. They consider themselves to be there to protect their serving alongside them. And they also ask the same question we do: why? What we're doing there? Death and silence is usually the answer. I want people to stop the killing of all women in Afghanistan. To these killings of civilian and military are premeditated murders. An infamous killer in the United States said there could be no apologies for premeditated murder. So Mr. Brown, your letter saying sorry to the three families just doesn't work. Our troops must be brought home now, on their feet, not on stretchers or in coffins. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, John, for that lovely moving